I wanted to be recognized as a god, and the people accepted that. I was filled with joy, because the life born on this planet accepted me. But with the dragon descent, everything changed.
The legendary dragon descent?
King Meridia started an uprising, accusing me of being a false god. He made the Skywalks crash to Earth in an attempt to kill me. As a result, the world was polluted with Hozon, and the common race was born.
King Meridia was our country's first emperor, right?
Why would someone start a revolt against me? When all I had done was select better laws to help guide the people. Perhaps my own existence was my downfall. That is when I realized that I was unable to choose the best laws.
Is that the reason you went to sleep?
Yes. I became unable to trust my own decisions. I relied on the Meridian bloodline, as they were the ones who fought against me. If they tried to kill me, maybe they'd select a law with their own logic. I guess the results were inevitable.
If you would just accept Lark's law, then we wouldn't have to go through this.
No, the future you seek has no place for any gods.
Ah. Now I understand. We never really had any choice but to kill you. Even if you had accepted my law, we'd still be right where we are now.
Yes. The Eesa system was already crumbling, since the moment I began to question myself. I had always realized it, but I just pretended like I hadn't. I was afraid that I would cease to exist if I did. My core is going to be destroyed. I understand your wish, Lark. My core will be gone, but my body will grant you the power you need. Now, go to the Hall of Eesa, the heart of all the Holy Land of Noir. This is the right choice, isn't it, Alu?
Thank you. All of you. I mean it.
Okay. What is it now?
Listen. Without Eesa's core, we won't be able to neutralize the Hozon.
What do you mean? Sonya said we could, though.
We need something in its place. Someone with the Eesa factor has to stay here and act as the core.
What are you saying, stay and act as a core?
I'm saying that now I have to say goodbye.
So that's it, huh? That's what Sonya had to tell you in private. Why didn't you tell us? I thought we were your friends!
Lark, you can't do this.
Oh, come on now. There's no need to be like that. It's not like I'm gonna die. I'll just be sleeping, like the divine race. And besides, I could sure use the rest.
But that means you'll never see any of us ever again.
Alf, take care of the Empire, will ya? Remember, my mom lives there.
Lark. I understand. I promise it'll be in good shape when you wake up.
And I'll change the Republic for the better. With Shelley, of course. Check that out too when you wake up.
I'll probably just be buried in the annals of history. But if you don't see anything written about me, I guess I lived a peaceful life.
I think I'll go back to sleep when this is over. Then you can see that I'll grow into a beautiful hero!
I think I'll live out my life in this generation. And besides, you don't need me to protect you at all anymore.
Riffia, I'm sorry.
Lark.
I'll be waiting for you in the future!